Can you hear me?
I can hear you.
Okay. So,
is it okay to others? Okay.
Yes, we can hear.
Okay. That's fine.
So, I will start with this work, joint work with Professor Sabir Umarov from University of New Haven, USA. And then after this, I will talk about some other results. This is Faidiev, is my colleague from National University. This is all about uniqueness of the inverse problem. And then next work is, this is inverse problem for wave equation. And then again, this is Faidiev, my colleague from National University. And then one more paper is with Professor Alimov. So, okay, now. So, consider this following problem. Let rho be a fixed number in between 0 and 1. And this is equation here. This is derivative of Riemann-Liouville. This is Laplace operator. And boundary condition is, this is outward normal vector. And so we have Neumann boundary.
Today, not for you.
And this is the initial condition. And this is, we call direct problem. And this direct problem was investigated by many authors. The most general case was considered by Ruzhansky with his colleagues, where he considered here an arbitrary self-adjoint operator, and he investigated generalized solution, existence of generalized solution. And classical solution was investigated, for example, by Pshu, Arsen Pshu, but he has constructed the green function when omega is just a product of one-dimensional intervals. So the main aim of our work is not only to solve this problem, but to find this the order of derivative, this Riemann-Liouville derivative. And to do this, we need some extra condition. And now I want to say that why we are considering here Neumann problem, because the method which we want to apply for this method, it is necessary that some eigenvalue should be equal to zero. So that's why we put here Neumann condition. And if we have apply here the Fourier method, then we come to the following spectral problem. And then this spectral problem, if a boundary is twice differentiable, then this has complete set of eigenfunctions and corresponding eigenvalues. And the main thing is that first eigenvalue is here zero and eigenfunction is constant. This we can see in this book, Ladijinskaya. So fractional derivative, this is a definition, everybody knows about that. We are now considering Riemann-Liouville fractional derivative, but at the end we will consider this Caputo derivative as well. One very simple property of Caputo derivative, which says that derivative of constant is equal to zero, very useful to investigate in this problem. But we start with Riemann-Liouville derivatives. So under certain conditions on this function, phi, initial function, this solution of this initial boundary value problem exists. And if it is, we denote by this function in fact depends on rho. And now our aim is to find this rho. To find this rho, we need to give to put some extra condition, and as an extra condition, we take the following integral. What is this integral? We take the solution and fix this time t zero. T zero should be greater than one, and then take this integral, and we take this integral. We got some number d zero. So if we know this d zero, then we can recover uniquely this rho. And if we have two pair of solutions, and both satisfy this condition four, then this both solutions must be coincide. So what is this four? Four, in fact, projection of the solution to constant. Constant, remember, in this case, it is first eigenvalue. So if you know this projection of the solution to first eigenvalue, then you uniquely recover the order of derivative. So just in two words, how we prove this. So this is a function of rho, and what we do is that derivative of this function on rho, it doesn't change sign. That means it is monotone. If this function is monotone, and this equation has solution, and this solution is unique. This is how we prove this. Okay, now, yesterday from Professor Mohtar Kerani, he sent me this paper. This is paper of his PhD student. Here he considered, he showed this derivative. You remember this is solution. It depends on X and T and also on rho. So if you take derivative on rho, then he showed that this derivative is satisfied the same problem as this function, but with other source term. So if he could show that this derivative, that is solution of some problem, doesn't change the sign, he could also obtain some solution for inverse problem. So this problem, you know, this is initial value problem and extra condition. This all together is called inverse problem. And here everybody knows that this is problem very important. And of course, uniqueness is here very important from application. Just now, Professor Yamamoto showed some results about uniqueness. And usually all investigators consider as an extra condition the following. So you fix it is some point of closed domain, maybe main boundary point, it may be inside the omega. And then if you have this function given, then you can show this. Many authors showed that there is a uniqueness. So there are a lot of works, but just now Professor Yamamoto has given a very good survey of these papers. So I will go very quick from this. This paper by Yamamoto and his colleagues here, this is the first mathematical result where he showed uniqueness of inverse problem for coefficients and also for order of derivative. And here, space times, here two parameters unknown, and also this is about uniqueness. Authors consider multi-term and here distributed order. And this work considered variable order, time fractional diffusion equation. And the main result here based on lemma 4.4.1, this is published in inverse problems. But unfortunately, this lemma is not correct. We constructed a counterexample and sent to the author and just, I mean, so this is not correct. So here in this work, authors showed the following property, that if you can count this limit, then this limit will be the order of fractional derivative. Yesterday, Karimov, Professor Karimov also sent me this work, and here in this work, also authors obtained. There is a survey paper, and it is just published in this handbook, and many works you can find in this survey paper. Now I want to stop on this Yano paper. Here, author showed existence. I think this is the only paper which I know where author showed in existence in how we understand. So he considered the time fractional diffusion equation derivative is with the Kato sense like this, and but he is in this inverse problem there are two unknowns. First is order of derivative and also kernel of some integral operator. And he has considered three types of initial additional data, and then here I want just to stop on this third one. So from our result, it follows that if you take this k is equal to v1, this is first eigenfunction, no need of knowing about this function for all t. It is just enough for one point, fixed point T0. If you know this, then you can recover the order of fractional derivative. So in this, I mentioned this short paper, and this paper, there are put some open problems. One of these open problems says that it should be interesting to find raw this of solution at fixed time. And if you observe in this paper, we are giving the answer for this question. So now we give a statement of result. So this pair, this is solution and this is parameter, we called the solution of inverse problem if rho is from here and if these functions from here and this is from here, and then all together they satisfied this this initial value problem and this additional condition. So here I should say one thing here, that we put here a closed domain. In fact, it is from, if you see this initial value problem, it is not necessary to put here a closed domain, but if you have here closed domain, it is easy to prove existence, uniqueness of classical solution. And at the same time, if you apply Fourier method, then you find the solution on this class. So that's why we put here closure. Okay, now we put the following conditions for initial functions. This is quite logical conditions, and then you cannot put here minus epsilon even, and this is we need for existence of classical solutions. So this is a theorem about direct problem. Let these conditions just we showed here. These three conditions. What is this? This is smoothness of phi, and this is some boundary conditions. Remember, B is normal derivative. So normal derivative, all these normal derivatives should be equal to zero on the boundary. Now, so if this satisfies, then there exists unique solution, and it has the following form. You see, many people applied Fourier method to solve this direct problem, but mainly they consider generalized solution. If you want to show existence of generalized solution, then you have to show that you put here A, the operator A, and you must show that this series, and you put here A, and then this A comes to this eigenfunction and gets from here one more lambda G, and then you must show that this series converges in L2 norm, but in L2 norm, using Parseval equality, then you just delete this and you have only number series. And this estimates of Mittag-Leffler function gives you everything. But whereas if you want to show that this converges in C, that is in norm of continuous functions, you take here derivative and then you take here derivative, and this function and derivatives of this function is not bounded. They are bounded only in one-dimensional case, and in multi-dimensional case, it is very fast going to infinity when z goes to infinity. That's why to investigate this existence of classical solution, it's quite problematic. But there are a lot of works by Ilyin and Professor Alimov, and this we are using these fundamental results. So this is inverse problem. Let this satisfy the conditions of previous theorem, because we need this, to exist classical solution. And first coefficient, Fourier coefficient of phi is not equal to zero. In this case, the inverse problem has solution u rho if on and only if this 9 is satisfied. Remember, here d0 is this number. So you take this number, put it here, and you know phi 1. If this relation satisfied, then okay, you have solution. And on this solution is unique. But if this number is more than, well, 1 or equal to 1 or less than 0, then there is no solution. There is no row satisfying this condition. I will not go through the proof, but I just tell the main point. So we use a Fourier method. So by Fourier method, you have this series, and where this T satisfies this Cauchy problem. And this Cauchy problem has this solution. And what we do is next is we use this fundamental result from this book. So what that if this is just a self-adjoint extension of the Laplace operator. Considering operator. Here we have norm in C, here we have norm in L2. So if this sigma is big enough, then this function, even G is only L2, from L2, this function will be continuous. But if it's big enough, then this continuous function, even you can derive it from a continuous function. So this, in fact, lemma based on coercitivity inequality, and in general case, it is proof is quite difficult, but in particular cases, we can prove it very easily. So, okay, then we use this lemma, and you see here, you want to show that this is converges in C. You put here this relation, so this order of this operator is equal to this, and put here this lambda here, the operator, and then use that lemma. So in that case, instead of estimating in C norm, you just go to L2 norm and then apply this Parseval equality. So this is the proof. Okay, now we go to inverse problem. Inverse problem, we prove the following lemma. Remember, this is this function. If phi 1 is not equal to 0, then this function as a function of rho is strictly monotone. So moreover, when rho tends to zero, this is zero, and when rho is equal to one, this is equal to phi one. And how to prove this? Just we take this solution and then integrate this solution. Remember this function is in fact integration of this, integral of this. So fix t zero here and take integral. You see, you remember first eigenfunction is constant, and then all other eigenfunctions is orthogonal to this constant. That's why here you have only first one. Here you go, first one, t is zero, and lambda one is equal to zero. This is necessary here, and then argument of this Mittag-Leffler function is zero. That means this is just gamma function. So you have here a function on rho, this is, and you just take derivative and show that this derivative is positive. And then to do this, we use this logarithmic derivative, and then this logarithmic derivative properties is here. If you calculate this derivative, it is just like this. Logarithm t zero is positive, and this is positive. So this function is increasing. This depends, increases or decreases. It depends on the sign of this phi one. Just here, you see here phi one, and this derivative of this function is positive. Okay, so this is the proof of inverse problem. Now, this was a result with our joint paper with Professor Umarov. So just to finalize what we have done, we consider, in fact, I here take Laplace, but in this work we take an arbitrary second order elliptic differential operator. So we consider this equation with zero here, homogeneous equation, rho is like this, and derivatives Riemann-Lewy will omega here, and these are unknown. So conditions lambda one is zero, and d is here, and then if satisfies this, then you have a unique solution. Next paper is instead of L, we put here. This is work with Professor Faizir from National University. We put here already an arbitrary elliptic differential operator. And one thing more, this is an arbitrary function. So not zero, so not homogeneous equation. So derivative is Riemann-Lewy, and unknown is U. And also rho, I know. So we use this result of Agmon and consider this boundary condition. So in this case, you have a complete set of eigenfunctions and eigenvalues. So T zero, T, this is the same condition as before, but here you have B one, which is the first eigenfunction here, and this is equal B zero. And t zero here should be bigger than this t zero, and this t zero is equal to this. Here phi one is you know, this Fourier coefficient of initial function, and f one is initial first Fourier coefficient of this function. So okay, now if the, so if tau is greater than this number, and phi is from domain of definition of this, and these conditions satisfied, then let t zero more than t zero, and in that case, inverse problem has solution if only if this inequality satisfied. So here, what is this? F one is equal to constant. You see, f is in fact a function of t and x. That means if you take Fourier coefficients of this function, this is in fact will be a function of t. So if this is, depends on t, this coefficient, then our our method doesn't work. Well, maybe it works, but it's complicated. That's why we put this condition that first free coefficient is constant, any constant satisfying this condition. So if you have this, then you have the answer for inverse problem. And next paper is this by me. Here we consider Riemann-Liouville derivative, but order, remember, before we were considering order less than zero, here in between one and two. So here we take this operator, just abstract operator, self-adjoint, doesn't matter bounded or unbounded. We consider here classical and generalized solutions, unknown of both these things, and conditions still here. So lambda one is equal to zero. So why we consider bounded operators as well? Because as an example, we can put here n-dimensional matrix and h n-dimensional Euclidean space, just fractional fractional equations. So so this result gives the answer for the system also. Okay, so once rho is between one and two, you need two conditions, and this condition is the same as before, and T zero is like this. So in this case, we have the following theorem. If D zero is in between these numbers, phi one is first free coefficients of first initial condition, and this is second one. So if this happens, then you have unique solution. So rho is unique, and if it doesn't happen, then you don't have solution. Okay, this is some, it has some interpretator. We can interpret it as follows, but I will not stop on this interpretation. So one thing more, recently I've seen this result. Here the authors consider, here unknown is not only rho here they consider in between 1.5 and 1, and also source functions unknown. And they put source function has the following special form. This is some functions. This is characteristic functions, indicator functions. So extra data is the following. Normal derivative when t is from zero to infinity. So x is from here. This is some part of domain. So in this paper also they prove uniqueness only, uniqueness, and they say that simultaneously to find rho and source function, it is quite difficult. So that's why we tried to find by our method both source function and this derivative order. So this is joint work with my colleague Fazi from National University. So here, omega is arbitrary domain. We are looking for classical solutions, and unknown is this u function. Unknown is right-hand side, and also unknown is this. So again, we suppose that first eigenvalue is zero. Of course, I should tell that not necessarily first eigenvalue. It is enough. Some eigenvalue is zero, maybe tens or twenties. Doesn't matter. If some eigenvalue is zero, then this method works. So again, this condition we give as an extra condition to find this rho, and this is the condition, just initial condition for this. And this is final time, and this condition we need to find this right-hand side of the equation. So we put this condition, both the same time is not zero, so we find T zero in these conditions, and then we have the following result. So this problem has unique solution. Unique means U, F, and Rho, if and only if this inequality is satisfied. So finally, we want to stop in this work. This is a joint paper with Professor Alimov, he's academician of Academy of Science of Uzbekistan. Here we consider Caputo derivative. You see, for Caputo derivative, this condition is not necessary. So any spectrum is good for this, for Caputo. So here A is an arbitrarily self-adjoint operator, and may, here we're looking for generalized solution, and unknown is this and this. Here we also consider non-homogeneous boundary conditions as well. So, okay. So the A is self-adjoint in H. By for Neyman spectral theorem, it has this form. This form. No, here A doesn't need to have discrete spectrum. It may have continuous spectrum as well. So this preparation of unity, it has the following property. So we consider the following Cauchy type problem. So rho, this derivative in Caputo sense, and phi is any given vector from H. So in this case, so what kind of examples we can consider as an operator A? First of all, we can take Laplace in L2Rn. This is spectrum is continuous. And secondly, we can take n-dimensional quadratic matrix, and then we have a linear system for fractional differential operator. And as example three, we can take compact inverse operator. In this case, spectrum is like this. This example three was considered by many physical examples discussed in Ruzhansky and his colleagues in this paper. And as an example, he has taken a fractional Sturm-Liouville operators, this which has a complete set of eigenfunctions, differential models with involution and fractional Laplacian and many others. All these examples which is here discussed in this paper, we can also take here. So now, what is the extra data? So as extra data, we should take such a thing which we can count easily. So this, we take here this this extra data. So this is operator, the scalar product, and this you can say as this one, this is in fact energy. If you have energy on time t0 and let it be d0, then we can consider this inverse problem. Let mu be greater than this. Remember, mu is this bounder. So operator is semi-bounded from below. So let mu be like this, and T0 satisfies this condition, and rho zero is, we are considering here, rho is from here. So rho zero like this. So for any phi, this function is monotonically decreasing with respect to rho. This is the main lemma here. And this is theorem. If this number is in between these two numbers, remember this decreasing function, and that's why this number is less than this number. So if this is from here, then there exists unique rho star from this domain, so that solution of this problem, Cauchy type problem, with rho equal rho star satisfied this condition. So that means this is the solution of inverse problem for determining the order of fraction. Note here, we are considering Caputo derivative, and that's why no need of lambda one equal to zero. So as a W, we can take many other examples. For example, if we take this function like this continuous, and such that this domain of this operator is inside domain of this operator, then as an extra data, we can take this function of t zero, and then for example, if you take this as one, then extra data is just norm square. So we can use the same result of this theorem for this case as well. So again, in that survey paper, in conclusion or open section, they stated one more open problem connecting that all other publications considering homogeneous boundary condition. Is it possible to consider for this inverse problem non-homogeneous boundary condition? For Caputo derivative, the answer is yes, but in very simple case when this is C0 constant. If this is constant, then you denote by W this difference between U and C0, and then you get new boundary value equation where this everything will be the same, but here zero. This is because of Caputo derivative. If you had here Riemann-Liouville derivative, then you cannot use this method. So actually that's it, whatever I wanted to tell in this workshop. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you very much. Very nice talk and very comprehensive survey part also. I highly appreciate. Now we have the time for questions and comments. Do you have any questions or comments?
I have one question.
Please.
For the question, for the problem where I believe we didn't start yet, is for the identification of the fractional power rho and the source term f, and where your operator A is function also of differential operator A x d.
Let me just go to that place. What you are interested for?
Yes.
Are you interested on this work?
No, without time. I believe source term, you ask it to identify rho and the source term without time, time independent, I believe. I think maybe that one, no problem, yes, that's okay.
You mean when this is also unknown?
Yes, I'm talking about in general, problems identifying the source and the fractional power.
This source and rho.
Yes, exactly, yeah. Yes. So my question is, what is the expression for the operator A for this case that depending on differential operator D, and also an example of that one, and also is the method the same as you write this one as the integral from mu to infinity or another method for that problem?
Okay, first of all, I should note that this T0 isn't equal to this. This is necessary. Okay. Because, you know, if this T0 equal to this P, and then this equation doesn't give any new information, because you take here this function, put here integrate, and that's why T0 is less than T. This capital T is final time. So what is A here?
Yes.
A is the same as in our previous work, like this. A is an arbitrary elliptic differential operator.
Okay.
Really, and with enough smooth coefficients. And this boundary condition is like this. How smooth these coefficients should be? This is from this work. So. This spectral problem was investigated by Agmon. This is quite old paper, 62. And he put some conditions on coefficients of this operator, coefficients of this boundary condition, and boundary of this domain as well. And if these conditions are satisfied, then this problem has complete set of eigenfunctions. So this is in our joint paper with Faizeev. The same condition, the same operator we put when we consider inverse problem when we have unknown U and source function and rho.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Any other questions?
Yes, please. There's one small, very good presentation, very good mathematics inside. I would like to ask you the following. Is there any physical meaning for the rho, for the order? Can you relate to some, give some physical meaning? Because from existence and uniqueness, stability, controllability, we are dealing with theorems. That's no problem. But when you go to reality, for example, I give an example. Take epidemiologic model, which is very simple. Take a data from COVID, for example, for Professor Kerbal, the country, or from Turkey, or from Italy, or from your country, the problems are different. The problems when I say that I identify means that I get to give to experimentalist or to doctor a number. My question is exactly as repeating a little bit. Can you identify irrational numbers? Or can you identify irrational numbers? And if so, with this method, what is the meaning, physical meaning? The rest, mathematics is very fine, very high level, and very similar with the classical inverse problems, with domains change, with the restrictions on the domains and many other, depending on derivative you like, you don't like, Riemann-Liouville, Caputo, Ries, A, B, or, it is a matter of test. Thank you very much in advance for your answer.
Thank you. So you mean, what is this rho? What kind of meaning it has? So I will tell this, you see, I will explain this to this question. You see, in fact, my first co-author, this Sabir, Professor Sabir Umarov, he, together with some colleagues from California University, he also investigated this COVID. And then he has the following graph prediction, and sometimes he put some rho from for this fraction of the differential operator, and he has not very good results. And he thought that maybe this rho is not correct. How to find this rho? How to define this rho? And then he put me this problem, and we have done this problem together. Of course, I can't say that this results you can straight away apply, but because his equations, what they are considering, they are nonlinear, and here we are considering linear. But this is motivation, how we came to this, to solve this.
Very good for young people, because if you say that we can do in general, independent on the model, just put a more general, I think is not very good for a physical viewpoint. This remains an open problem, and it will remain an open problem, like geometrical meaning and physical meaning of the derivatives. Whatever Riemann-Liouville, Caputo, other kernel, maybe not interested for your group, but the problem also is to identify which kernel gives the best fitting. For example, in COVID, is power law kernel or other kernel, if of associated with fractional operator or with integral operator, if you don't agree on fractional operator. Thank you very much, and sorry for interrupting.
Okay, thank you very much. It is very good notice. Okay, thank you. Any questions?
May I ask a question? Hope just a short question. In many cases, you have proved the unique existence of the solution, satisfying also rho and satisfying some value of rho. Then my question is that, how about the stability?
Oh, no. We can consider stability, but you know, Professor Yamoto, I think it can be done because, you know, this is, in fact, Roy is very solution of very simple equation.
Yes, like a gamma function. Something is involving
Roy is the solution of this equation. This is, in fact, very smooth functions. T0 is not zero, you know, this is a full function, and then I think it can be done, but we didn't do this job.
Okay, it looks that more or less the continuity depends on the gamma functions.
Yes.
Okay. I see. Yeah. Okay, thank you very much.
I have one more question, please.
Yeah, please.
I just a question about anyone or in this using some method now for rho, but if what happened if rho, for example, is variable order, it depends, for example, on the state or in the unknown function or something similar to that.
You see, this method is based on the solution of a direct problem. You see, this is first we must have this solution, and when rho is some function on T, then we cannot use this method and find this solution. So here we can apply this method only in case when rho is a constant.
Anything done or thinking about treating that rho a variable order?
Yes, I told you before that the only paper which I have seen rho is variable. I don't know what is that. I have seen only one paper where rho is variable here. This paper, which is published in 2019.
Okay. Can you keep that page? I just want to take pictures on this just for reference.
First problem.
Yeah, thank you.
It showed uniqueness, but unfortunately, this is not correct. Maybe correct, but this lemma, basic lemma, is not correct.
I see.
I don't know any other result here.
Okay, thank you.
By the way, just one comment about the physical background. Because I know the second author very well, Professor Jin Chen, and he has been interested in such a variable order. Because that is quite a reasonable one physical model where something like a rho depends on the location. For example, some part is more sand, other part is like a mud. Then good reason that rho depends on X. Usually maybe characteristic function or something like that. But anyway, this is just a usual physical background. Of course, I'm not so familiar with the physics. But anyway.
In diffusion, you are right. There are few phenomena describing variable coefficients, but not very many. And also, if you try to think in fuzzy fractional, for example, also there is another type of. So there are a lot of open problems here only in diffusion, for viscoelastic, viscoplastic, and so on. Very, very big problems. How to write the models? How to prove the resistance, how to use the inverse problem, how to control the mechanism. So with variable order, there are a lot of papers by friends from China, Liu, for example, from Australia, and and so on. So you can see existence, uniqueness, and even numerical ideas, but I don't know exactly the inverse problems. And if what are the novelties, what are the difficulties, what are the benefits? Thank you.